Hello, my name is David, and it's truly an honor to share God's word with you today. I love living in Korea. I think it's wonderful. It's fantastic. It's very convenient. You can get anything delivered to your door at any given time of the day, and it's a beautiful country to live in. However, one of the downfalls to living in Seoul right now, it's the pollution. You know, sometimes when you go out and you can't see anything because there is this yellow dust or fine dust that's just covering the air. And on the streets, you see everyone wearing these white masks, you know, or black masks. And everyone is wearing these masks to kind of protect themselves and to protect it from the fine dust. What I realize is that even though you wear this mask, it doesn't solve the problem because the problem is, you know, the pollution, it's the fine dust itself. So unless you remove the pollution or the fine dust, you're going to be forever have to wear a mask. And that is like our sinful state. If you don't get to the root of the problem, you're not going to fix your sinful heart. In the Old Testament, what the high priest did was he would offer a sacrifice for himself, for his sin, and then he would offer a sacrifice for the people because everyone was a sinner. But that was just a part of, that was covering the problem. It was covering the sin. It wasn't removing the sin. It was pretty much like wearing a mask for pollution. It doesn't solve the problem, but it's pretty much a temporary solution to the problem. It's not a long-term solution. But when Jesus Christ came and he died on the cross, he was able to remove the sin problem from our hearts because, you know, once Jesus Christ, he died on the cross, because he was the perfect sacrifice and because of his blood, our sins were atoned for and we're able to, that's why today we don't offer sacrifices to God because of Jesus Christ. He was the ultimate sacrifice. And that's what Paul is getting to at in Colossians chapter 1, verses 15 to 23. It's the supremacy of Christ and why we don't need anything else other than Jesus Christ. And this was so important to the early church because a lot of the Jewish culture, they still relied on other things other than Christ. So let's get into today's text.
Colossians chapter 1, verses 15 through 23. The Son is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn over all creation. For in him all things were created, things in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or powers or rulers or authorities, all things have been created through him and for him. He is before all things, and in him all things hold together. And he is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning and the firstborn from among the dead, so that in everything he might have the supremacy. For God was pleased to have all his fullness dwell in him, and through him to reconcile to himself all things, whether things on earth or things in heaven, by making peace through his blood shed on the cross. Once you were alienated from God and were enemies in your minds because of your evil behavior. But now he has reconciled you by Christ's physical body through death to present you holy in his sight, without blemish and free from accusation. If you continue in your faith, established and firm, and do not move from the hope held out in the gospel. This is the gospel that you heard and that has been proclaimed to every creature under heaven and of which I, Paul, have become a servant.
We call this portion of this text the Messiah poem because it really clearly shows that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, that Jesus Christ is God, and that's who all we need. We don't need anything other than Jesus Christ. And verse 15 and 16, the Son is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn over all creation. For in him all things were created, things in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or powers or rulers or authorities, all things have been created through him and for him. And we see this again in John chapter 1. In the beginning was God, and God was with the Word, and the Word was God. So we know that Jesus Christ, He was with God even before the beginning of time, even before the world was created. Jesus was there. The Spirit was there. We see in Genesis chapter 1, verse 16, I think the Spirit of God hovered before the water. So we see this Trinity at work even before anything was created. And this idea, this theology in particular, was so important, especially for the early church, because there was a lot of heresy going around saying that, no, Jesus Christ was created afterwards, the Spirit was created afterwards, and all this nonsense. They were kind of knocking Jesus down, and the gospel that Paul preached was, you know, he was just saying, listen, Jesus Christ is the Son of God. He is God, and He was there with God even before the beginning of time. And, you know, God is, it's all we need, you know. All we need is the blood of Jesus Christ, and that in itself is sufficient. Jesus' grace, God's grace, is enough for us to cover anything, and especially for Jews who kind of emphasize the importance of circumcision, and for them, the law was their savior. It wasn't Jesus Christ who was their savior. It was for them. They needed to obey God's law for them to go to heaven. So for them, the law was the utmost importance. It wasn't Jesus Christ. Paul is trying to change their mindset. Hey, listen. We know that this law has been in effect in our culture for thousands of years, but we need to change our mindset because God gave us a new covenant. We don't need anything else. And verse 21, it says, once you were alienated from God and were enemies in your minds because of your evil behavior, but now He has reconciled you by Christ's physical body through death to present you holy in His sight, without blemish and free from accusation. So Paul is saying Jesus Christ is the bridge between us and God. Before Jesus Christ, we had to offer sacrifices to have communion with God, because God is holy, we're sinners, and because God is so holy, we were unable to approach Him, and anyone who saw the face of God just died instantly, because that's how holy God was. But now, through Jesus Christ, and because of Jesus Christ, He works as a bridge. He's the mediator between us and God. And that's what Paul is saying. You know, before we were dead in our sins, but now we were made alive through Jesus Christ. And verse 20 says, and through Him to reconcile Himself all things, whether things on earth or things in heaven, by making peace through His blood shed on the cross. And Jesus was the ultimate answer to the sin problem. In the past, the reason why the Israelites had to offer sacrifices was because of their sinful nature, and that wasn't solving the problem. That was pretty much covering the sin through their sacrifice. It's pretty much us wearing masks when there's a lot of pollution outside. It doesn't solve the problem, but because of the blood of Jesus Christ, which was shed on the cross, that solves the sin problem. It takes the sin away. Just as, you know, if there was a magical solution to take away all the pollution on this earth, that's what Jesus Christ did, and that's why Paul is saying this is all we need. We don't need the law. We don't need all these Jewish cultures and things that are in place of Jesus Christ. Those things are not gonna give us eternal life. It's only Jesus Christ. He is the way, the truth, and the life, and no one goes to the Father except through Jesus Christ, and that's what Paul is preaching. And in verse 3, he concludes by saying, if you continue in your faith, established and firm, and do not move from the hope held out in the gospel, this is the gospel that you heard and has been proclaimed to every creature under heaven, and of which Paul have become a servant. So he's saying, if you hear any other gospel than this, that is false teaching. Hold on to this. If anyone tells you that there is another way to heaven besides Jesus Christ, they're teaching you a false gospel. The only way to heaven is Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ is not a means to an end. He is the end. If we were to go to heaven and Jesus Christ wasn't there, then you're not going to get to heaven, if that's your mindset. Jesus Christ is heaven itself. And the reason why we want to go to heaven is to have communion with God and with Jesus Christ. And this was what Paul was preaching. And this is the reason why a lot of people were being swayed from the truth, because they, one, didn't want to believe this, or they were exposed to other false teachings. So let's go in time of prayer. Jesus Christ is the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega. He is the head of the church, and He is the only thing we need to get to God. He is the bridge between us and God. And Paul preached the supremacy of Christ. We don't need anything else, you know, because there were some Jewish people who are worshiping angels. They believe that angels were messengers of God. There were people saying that Moses was, the one that could take us to God. But Paul is saying, listen, throw away all your cultural bias or, you know, whatever things that we have believed in the culture to be true. Put away the law. All we need is Jesus Christ, and His blood and His grace is sufficient for us. So I pray that may be our mindset as well, that if we hear any false teachings, that we could go to heaven without Jesus Christ. We know that that's obviously a false teaching, and I pray that we may just hold on to this truth that Christ is superior than anything else, and that's all we need in our lives. Pray for us and we'll end. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the word you have given us today. Just as Paul preached the supremacy of Christ to the Gentiles, I pray that we may hear this message today, and I pray that we may realize that Christ's blood was sufficient for us. His grace is sufficient for us. We don't need anything else. There's no way we could compensate anything else in order to get to heaven. We know that we go to heaven through Jesus Christ, and He is the way, the truth, and the life. And I pray that that we may be able to distinguish between the lies of the enemy and the truth that is in the Bible. So help us, give us a spirit of discernment, give us wisdom, so that we may know what is truth and what is not. We thank you. We love you, and in your precious name we pray. Amen. This program is 시청자 여러분의 소중한 후원으로 제작됩니다.